of India, well, everybody else, Tuncha, Vanek, and heading all on 122. Didn't have to shoot to stay in, but they did have to shoot for position, and that is how it has finished up. Hales and heading, the two Brits first and sixth, in between them Ki Ying second, Viraj Tondeman of India, Tolga Tuncha, and Pavel Vanek. Well, the other athletes, Czech Republic, I think I might have just forgotten to mention them as an honourable mention. And there's ice lollies all around. Fair enough, these officials have earned them. You can revive them. These athletes will be wanting one when they finished. The president has one as well. Wow. It's that kind of day. I went to Salo yesterday, which is around to the west, to the northwest of De Sanzano on the lake. They had some very nice ice lollies there. It was very warm. I spent some time in the museum, which is very nice. It also had aircon. Earlier in the week, last week, we had temperatures touching 40 degrees. So in a way, I guess we should be thankful. And whatever the conditions, it's the same for all six, of course. Those are the seats in the shade. The bleachers next door, if you're lucky, and at the top, are a little bit cooler as well. But if you're in the direct sunlight, well, a lot of the people watching this are watching it. There you go, in the shade. A few steps back. In fact, a few more steps forward, because the trees are providing a bit more shade, a bit closer. But that's exactly where you want to be. You don't really want to be in the sunshine if you can possibly help it. Showing the targets to the athletes. Around they'll go. Then we'll get the test fire, and then we'll be underway, I reckon, within 5 minutes, because we have to be introduced officially to these six athletes. Remember, a different way of doing things. Not the first final, the first event to have it like this. But, six athletes, not two semi-finals of four each. And remember, 25 targets, sixth place leaves, five more fifth place, five more fourth place, five more bronze, and then 10 more targets, gold and silver, is decided. All on bib numbers apart from gold and silver. I know I've told you this before, but I thought, just in case you've joined us, it'd be nice to let you know. Four watching the targets, two deciding to sit in the shade. All six will be out with us shortly. That's Aaron heading. I wonder if he's updated his biography yet. Let's have a little look. And he still lists his other sporting activities as badminton and ballet. You may remember we did a daily report from Cairo with Aaron and Nathan by the poolside. And, well, he did admit that he doesn't really indulge in ballet too much, but he did do a very nice dismount into the pool, which was very balletic. Here he is wearing six. Keying, just taking on some more cartridges. The student, 26 years of age now. You see Tandai Man, a veteran almost at 36. Good afternoon, Mr. President. He not only has a front row seat, he has a seat in the shade. And by the looks of it, someone brought him an ice lolly. That's the only thing I envy him, is the ice lolly. Willie Grill, the Secretary General, looking cool in his shades. He said to me earlier today that my shades, I was too old for the shades I was wearing. I didn't take offence. I asked an Italian, Ivan Carella, who took a short pause, slightly longer than it should have been, before saying, no, you're fine. I'm going to wear them come what may. So then, enough of the frivolity. Ready to get underway in this men's final. Here we go. Clayton will get a tap on the shoulder. And he will lead these athletes out. Great Britain, China, India, Turkey, and the Czech Republic represented in these six athletes. Into the sunshine. It's a hot old gig for Clayton, you know. Gets extra cold milk afterwards. Hales, Ki, Tondaiman, Duncha, Vanneken. Heading without a cap, not the thing he enjoys. It is the exception to what is normally the rule. Well, we've turned around very quickly from the women's competition. It's great that we're ready. Here he is. He gets his own introduction. Clayton, the official mascot of the Trabzonspor Verde. He features on this game that they've made. Hopefully, I am asking whether they can be made perhaps available on websites on the IWSF. We'll see. But yeah, very, very fun. It's like you're almost sat on the positions yourself. Here is Aaron Heading, the man from King's Lynn, now lives in Long Sutton, from the East Yorkshire Gun Club. Pavel Vanek, well, he's very experienced, isn't he? 29 years of age now, looking for his first gold. He has silvers, junior world championships, team in Osijek, yet to get himself on top of the podium. Togo Tuncha, the 30-year-old, Sultan Hisse is from where he is. Another one without a gold medal. He has a silver in the mixed team in trap this year from Almaty, and last year mixed team from Baku, a bronze. But wouldn't he like to get his first individual World Cup medal? And here's a man who has won gold, and that is a team trap in New Delhi on home turf in 2021. He has won bronze medal individually in Doha this year. So, of course, in pretty good form, it has to be said. And we were talking, weren't we, to Russell and Mark and his wife, and just finished working with the Indian team. And it'll be bittersweet, won't it, to see for them how they've gone. And Ki Ying, very sensibly, with a headband to stop that sweat dripping over your eyes. The man from Jibo City has his support here as well. Has his fair share of golds, including Changwon last year in the World Cup. Grand Prix trap. Gold in the Grand Prix for him. And top of qualification, Nathan Hales, the 27-year-old, is here with his wife and his infant baby, man who was part of that World Championship trap team men last year. He enjoyed themselves in Osijek. Does have a bronze medal from Tuscan, but that was, what, 5 years ago now. Even the Cypriots are finding it hot to remember in charge, a little puff of the cheeks. Christophe Busch is our referee from France. It's warm, but it's the same for all six. Let's see how we go. It's the men's final in the trap competition here at Trabzonspor Verde, our last competition of this wonderful World Cup. Thank you to our organisers, to the whole team here in Italy. Goodness me, it's still warm as we go through the test fires, and then we'll be underway. Remember, 25 targets each before we lose our first athlete. Then we have five more before fifth, fourth, and bronze, and 10 targets before we decide gold and silver. Just a chance to get used to the conditions for the athletes. Marco Michelli has done great stuff with the British team. Zhang Zhongzhe very sensibly with a towel around his neck, keeping himself in the shade as much as possible. There is no cover for the coaches. Petr Hrdlika of the Czech Republic. Punch above their weight, don't they, the Czech Republic? Some wonderful athletes in the track discipline. Jan Palicki was also on 122 here for ranking points only. Otherwise, they might have had two in the final. We're underway. Nathan Hales and Ki Ying both start in the green. Tom Diamond not so good from Vanek. Now here comes Aaron Heading. Got a nibble of that one. It was high to the right hand side. Not sure where wife and baby are watching, possibly inside in the cool. Tondeman, 36 years of age now, would like his first individual World Cup gold. Aligure of Turkey is out there without a cap. He's a braver man than me. Heading and Hales taking the limelight for Great Britain. Sorten taking up the reins in the Indian camp in the coaching position. Russell Mark, as we say, the coaching and head of performance, moved on to Qatar. A different chapter for them. Action took a lot of time and effort to get through qualification. 196 athletes taking part, quite a few with ranking points only against their name, but certainly massive for these organizers to get it sorted. So far, so good for all bar the Indian, and even being one behind this early on, not too much of a worry. Here's Heading for Great Britain, way to the right hand side. Gust of breeze wafts its way around this stadium. Everything is gratefully received. No mistake thus far from Hales. Qiying looking good as well. China, one of these nations like India, such a big population to draw from. It's just getting enough people involved. 26 years of age, but only just inside the top 100 in the rankings. He'll certainly go up now, Will Key. And looks very composed as well. Pavel Vanek always looks composed. Tall man. We had quite a few misses early on in the women's competition. Not so here. Many in the red. It's all a bit calm before the storm here at the moment. There we go. Tuncha with his first. Interesting that Hales and Heading are here. They had a very good qualification, of course. 123 and 122, respectively. Oh, and the first miss for Heading. But it can be sometimes not your day. Matt Cowan-Holly, the world champion, former world champion, down on 100, finished with a couple of 19s. It's sometimes might be an issue with your shotgun, might be an issue with form, might be an issue with injury. It's not your day, but those with class will always bounce back. So a miss from Tuncha and Heading in the last go around. Vanich, 29 years of age now. Junior World Championship silver medal. So what, 10 years ago now? Ooh, another one. Another one in the red. And Hales takes his first missed target. 25 though, it's a long way to go. Tonde Man with a miss as well. Second for him. Now Vanek, rather. Way to the left, no problem at all. Yeah. Shadows are lengthening, but they're not going to reach the field of play, that's for sure. Here's the left-hander now, Aaron Heading. I beg your pardon, Nathan Hales. It was Heading who just took the shot. Because Key is next. Already up to almost 10 targets each. And you don't want to leave yourself too much work. We saw that in the women's competition, that if you're two or so shots behind, there's only five targets to overhaul that deficit. You are obviously at the mercy of other people. Been a red dot fest, has it, so far? Here's Hales. Way to the right hand side, not a problem for lefty. Now Key all the way along in position one. One diamond. In his setup, not the most difficult target for him. Level with Key on 10, and everyone else, bar Tom Dimon on 9. I'm always fascinated by the different calls of pull. Doesn't have to be pull, can be anything you want, as long as the microphones can pick it up. And if you saw our data report yesterday, you'll know it goes bouncing back to the electronics to my left, and then bouncing underneath. And if you stand in the trap when there is a competition, there are six athletes up above, you can see the groupings of three, and automatically it'll know which of the three and where it's going, and because it's been programmed. Trajan did say if it goes wrong, sometimes he's down there running from one to the other, doing it manually. But as he did say, it's a last resort. It's tight at the moment. Key mixing it at the top. The Indian athlete here struggling a little bit. Miss. A miss from Tuncha. That leaves him down in a very tight field, of course. In fifth at the moment. Heading with a chance to leapfrog everybody. At least get away from sixth place. But that's the problem with the bib number, isn't it? If you've got you're happy to be there, you are not happy that the shoot-off didn't go your way. First target missed. Then at four targets, both Tuncha and Vanek missed. They have to go and be separated by countback, and then just outperforming Tondim and the other two. And more than halfway to the first point of this final. Way to the right. It was a tricky one. Didn't catch it. Wind just getting up a little bit. Nice from Nathan Hales. He, like a lot of us, has brought family here to enjoy not just the competition, but also the wonderful scenery around here, the wonderful food. Wine's not bad either, if truth be told. But it is warm, Italy in a heat wave. It's warmer down south. I made it before the competition got underway. I arrived a bit early getting to Venice. That's a warm city in July. Beautiful but warm. Heading back into the green again, but at the bottom at the moment, 3 on 12 as we head on to our 15th set of targets. Hales. Still rolling at the top with Key. Ooh, who misses one? Little look from side to side from the referee. The side referees agree. So that advantage is gone. And Tondimon in even more trouble now. Tuncha can just get the advantage over the Indian. But remember, Tondimon just one behind. And he has a pretty decent bib number. Number three. All based on qualification of all, of course. This is heading. Man from the east of England. Absolutely loves this sport. Would very much like to find himself on the podium. Couple of World Cup goals for heading. But the last one was 5 years ago. The other one was 10 years ago. Poland and the UAE. Vanek. Czech athlete, no Italians in the final. There's a man looking for his first gold of his career, his senior career. He has team World Cup silvers and World Championship silvers. European Championship junior bronze. But this is at a different level, individually, at a World Cup, at Lenato. And we have some wonderful ranges, but Lenato has a certain cachet about it. Bit more breeze, certainly up at the top of the bank. There's a little bit of movement off the tarpaulin. Nice target, not too far to the left for Heading, who, as you can see from his neck, is developing a good tan here in Italy. Sun cream is never far away from these athletes. Hale's looking good. Getting towards the moment when it all starts to speed up and athletes have to take their seats. Tandeman may be the first one. He's certainly got to keep hitting the green. The others will be looking over their shoulder. Tuncha is one of them. At the moment, Kia with the miss, of course, not that far ago. But we are getting into a pattern of all green again. Only two between top and bottom. Six targets left before we decide who has to exit first. Never a nice feeling. It's always great to make the final. You'll get respect from your fellow athletes for that. However, you want to do a bit more than that if you possibly can. Here's Tuncha. So far, so good in this round of five. Spoke too soon. Commentator's curse. Vanek with the miss. Heading leaps over Tom Diamond into fifth and into safety, but there's a long way to go. Targets now. There we are, another five after this. One more go around all five positions. Another miss. It's the same target, same location. Went away to the left as well. Vanek didn't enjoy the previous station. He enjoyed that one a bit more. Heading at five. Ooh, straight down the middle, and he says he hits it. He said he hit it. Hand went up straight away. So did the coaches. Marco. And the referee will go and have a wander in this heat. Didn't see anything from where we are, but Aaron Heading knows how important this target is to stay in the competition. And he'll go and have a conversation with both of the side referees. Different angles, of course, different side of view. And it doesn't look good for Aaron. No, it stays. There's nothing you can do about it because there's no VAR. They'll trundle past the referee. Probably not make eye contact. That's a real shame. It was a straight away. It looked pretty down the middle. He was convinced he'd hit something. So Aaron heading on 17, not where you want to be. But, especially you know, with the bib number six, leaves him in sixth place. The other British athlete, Hales, is at the other end of the battle. Key is his main concern, who's looking in very good form. Oh, and that is a miss. Another one from the Indian. Now then, Aaron Heading may be breathing a sigh of relief, but he's still got some work to do. That is what, fourth miss. President Viraj Tondaiman. Vanek has no problems. Heading is back round at one. And that is a miss. Oh dear. Well, had a chance to get a foothold in this competition and spurned it. Hales is in the zone at the moment. What about Ki Ying? Both with just the one miss. What about Vanek? Can he? Yeah, it does well. It was away to the left hand side, not too high, which helps. Now Heading. He is flashing red. That's better. It was a low one to the right, not the nicest, but that'll give him a bit more confidence. A couple of misses in a row for the British athlete. Still not out of it at the moment. Keep your eyes on Tondiman. Those two are the ones in danger. Heading is running out of targets, though. That's better from the Indian. It was a benign target. And you're going to get in these 25 from each station, two to the left, two to the right, one straight down the middle. It's a question of when. Vanek. Never right off the checks. He's found a bit of form after those two misses. Heading needs this one, and he gets it way to the left-hand side. Hales. And he looks in good nick, doesn't he? And so does this man next to him. They shot off for good position. Both shot 123. Only went to the third target in favour of Hales. Tondiman keeps himself in this competition. Leaves Heading ruining that miss three targets ago. And he's definitely going to have to hit the next two and see what Tondiman does. If he hits the next one, he gets through. Simple and effective from Vanek. Heading, he'll no doubt be feeling the pressure. Took his time, did well. the last set of targets before we pause and thank our sixth place athlete. Hales is in excellent form. Key has followed him all the way through. Thondimann does enough. He'll be happy with that because he started poorly with a miss in each of the first five. And Heading will look to equal him, but it won't be enough because the bib number. It doesn't matter anyway. He has missed the last one and obviously knew what was going on. A little look at the scoreboard. And Aaron Heading, little wave to friends and family. The man from Lincolnshire in England misses out on his chance to get on the podium. The man who's ranked 50th in the world ends up sixth here. So, five more. One more go around these five targets for these athletes. And we will know who takes fifth place. Everything starts to speed up a little bit. Thondimann dotted with reds. Hales with just the one. A little bit before Key Ying. Those are the two who have 1 point advantage over Pavel Vanek, who's come back into it nicely. Hales keeping the pressure on the man next to him. Oh, and misses. He misses. He misses. A little look left to right from Christophe Busch, our French referee. Yeah, well, now then, we're a long way away. We have half the competition to go for two of these athletes anyway. But will that make a difference? Nicely done. It was rising, that's for sure. Way to the right for the Indian, who managed to stay in but will be under pressure now. Each miss is magnified. So Tuncher and Thondimann on 23, and of course Tuncher with the number 4 bib, one lower or higher, depending on how you look at it. Ooh. And a miss there as well for Vanek. So that puts a bit of clear water between certainly him and Hales, who has hit his target. Nasty one away to the right for the Chinese. Key does well. Oh, and another one. Another miss. Thondimann this time. Well, Hales ahead. One from Key. Vanek missed last time. Not this time. Away to the left. Not a problem. Two more targets before we lose our next athlete. Hales in great nick at the moment. Missed his, what was it, eighth target, and that was it. Key, two targets missed, hence just one target behind. 28 and 27 for the top two. Oh, and Tuncher, two misses in three. Keeps him bottom of that battle with Thondimann. Hales, Key, Vanek, Thondimann and Tuncher at the moment. That's how it looks. There we go. This is the last chance saloon And at the moment, it's Tuncher on bib number. Hales and Key are moving serenely on. That'll do it for Tondiman, who is clinging on precariously in this competition. Tuncher finishes with a miss. So the bib number becomes academic. And a good finish from Vanek. So Tondiman stays in it, but he's a little bit behind. Well done, Targa Tuncher. Not quite into the podium places. Still looking for that first gold in a World Cup. The man from the Aden Shooting Club in Sultan Hisa doesn't quite make it through past Tondiman, who has kept going, hasn't he? He's got a bit of a work to do in the next five. Two behind Vanek. He does have the advantage of the bib, of course. We shall see. At the top, Hales and Key are certainly battling it out. Another five for these athletes. Then we will know who's on the podium. Tondiman, one of these guys who just has a habit pulling it out of the fire, but him and Vanek, you suspect, will be the two fighting it out. You don't want to miss here, Pavel, and he doesn't. Pavel Vanek, as I said, just inside the world's top 100, but certainly has shown a very good show here, both in qualification and the final. Hales had four 25s and then 123 the second round in qualification. What do you mean, mystified perhaps? I don't know. He's been in very good form, but the finals are a different matter, aren't they? Tondiman is the man at the bottom. Hales with a nice one down the middle, stays in front. Pressure back on Keying. Pressure? What pressure? University student is feeling absolutely at home for World Cup, or four gold medals, not all in the World Cup, but he did have that one in Changwon, of course, last year. And he's done good stuff as well in the Junior World Cup. All green in this five so far from these athletes. Just resetting the clock. Back to the... clock is out of shot on the right-hand side. Got to go back to 12. It is back to 12. No problems for Hales. A little bit of cloud around. There was a little bit of shadow. That was a nasty target, but right in the middle from Keying. It was a bit of a snatch from Vanek away to the left. I don't think whether he was expecting it to be counting targets, I don't know, but certainly seemed that he snatched away. Hales, meanwhile, enjoys another one down the middle. And he's been in great form, hasn't he, the British athlete? Wife and baby will be watching. Well, certainly the wife will be watching. The baby may not be. Time to wipe your brow and wait for your turn as Vanek. That's Tondiman. Well, This is an important one, isn't it? Need to have this one. Oh! It's a miss. It's a miss. He cannot believe it. On the last shot. Oh, dearie me. What drama. Just needed that one to stay in and take something from the podium. Oh. Fourth place on bib number, and somehow Tondoman stayed in the competition again. I think he's managed to smile about it now. Oh, why? What a turn up. This is the last one. I'd hit the last six. Looked. There's more than that, but yeah. Well, we know who's on the podium. Anyway, that's for sure. At the moment, Tondeman, who's been scrabbling to stay in all the time, is on track for that bronze medal. But you never know. He's a battler. Again, low to the right, not a problem for Hales. Pressure back on the Chinese athlete. That was a nasty one as well, but looks smooth in the execution. Less time to get yourself ready, of course. Hales looks composed. Soon as the rifle, sorry, the shotgun is ready, the clock starts to count down. Got the target away with a couple of seconds to go on the clock. They turn red. Now it clicks down for Key. These two locked in great battle. Oh, yes, down the middle. That's meat and drink to Tondeman. You might have heard us in previous data reports talking to the Indian contingent, you know, feeling that they, of course, are dominant along with the Chinese in rifle and pistol, but they have the resources if they can find the talent. Told him when it is, he'll take the bronze. Another miss from the Indian. That'll confirm it. Hales then. At the moment, just the one miss. His eighth target. Out of what these 40. That's a couple of misses. It's fine margins, isn't it? A couple of misses from Keying. And a hit to finish off. But Prithviraj Tondeman will be delighted. He takes a bronze medal. His coach will give him a big embrace. And a thumbs up for us. Well done. Prithviraj Tondeman, the 36-year-old, takes another medal, his second bronze individually after that bronze in Doha. Yes, a gold. The Indian in New Delhi in that trap team competition. But yeah, another individual will be very precious to him. Two left then. Great Britain against China. It's Hales against Key. It's the top two qualifiers. Very nearly gone to qualification. 10 more targets and we will know. It's tight, isn't it? Mentally, can you keep up with the pressure? They both look pretty good. In the hands of Hales. Remember, if it is tied at 50 targets, we go to shoot off. And looking at these two, it could take a while. Chinese coach is as cool as a cucumber. Well, that's what he's kind of giving up. The vibes he's giving off, I'm sure inside he's a little bit, as Sir Alex Ferguson said, in football terminology, a squeaky bum time. You kind of, everything's clenched. You're hoping for the best. These two going toe to toe. A man in the Union flag, air defenders. Marcello Marcelli. Watching on in the heat. Still mid-30s here. Left-hander over on the far right, the Chinese opponent on the far left. Nicely done, rising to the left. He's keeping his counsel. Once more around then for these two. Hales taking his time to get around, getting his mind in the right place, perhaps. One step closer. Four more targets for him. Becomes increasingly like a shoot-off, doesn't it? The closer you get. That was a tricky one. Low to the right. Still no expression from our Chinese coach. He will be pleased, delighted, I am sure, whatever the colour of the medal. And it's as much a mental game now as a physical game. Up high to the right, not a problem. Two targets left. He's almost there. He's almost there. But no, another two targets after this. My excitement's getting to me for these two athletes. Goodness me. 49 and 50 to go. Two more targets. My mathematics, as you know, never my strong point. It is hot, it is sweaty out here. It's also a bit nervy around this arena. Round of applause from the crowd. He's got one more to go. It's in his hands. Keane needs this one. Well, Nathan Hales, this is your moment. Are you going to fluff your lines or get a standing ovation from the audience? He will take his time. He will wait until everyone's ready. Our referee says start. He does it. He does it. And it is Aaron Heading who leads the cheer. Well done. Family are there to watch it. And it is gold for Great Britain. It is gold for Nathan Hales. Well done to him. And well done to Qi Ying of China as well. Hales it is. who takes the gold. It is Great Britain who get the top stepper of the podium. And Ki Ying, he has really pushed him very, very far indeed. Silver for him. It is a first World Cup gold for the British athlete. And there'll be some celebrations tonight, I suggest. It is Prithviraj Tongdimun of India with the bronze, Ki Ying of China with the silver, and well done to Great Britain's Nathan Hales, who takes the gold.
Thank you.
Prithviraj, congratulations. Bronze in Doha, bronze here. How does it feel?
It's a great feeling. Could have been better, but yes, it was a tight final. Hung in there, won a bronze. Maybe the next one would be better, for sure.
It was tight, but somehow you clung on and got onto the podium. I kept saying, oh, he's in trouble here, and you never in the end quite were.
That's true. I try and hit as many as possible. That's how it works. I tried my best, and I hung in there, and it worked out.
World Championships next. You must be feeling in great form.
Yes, going into the World Championship, I'm working with my coach, Anwar Sultan, and we have a plan in place, and yeah, this is great confidence to go into the World Championship, that's right.
I did see you getting a slap on the back from Russell Mark, who's obviously now at Qatar, but he was delighted to see you do well as well.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I'm what I am because of him today. I mean, he helped me a lot, and he put my shooting into place, and I really have to thank him a lot. Thank you, Russell, for everything.
Well, we'll keep an eye on how you do. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Ian, congratulations. That was a very exciting final.
他说非常祝贺你，就是这是一个非常精彩的一个决赛，一场决赛。
好，谢谢，谢谢。
Okay, thank you. Glad to meet
you. How do you feel? Because you were so close to gold. You had a very good final. Tell us your thoughts.
他说你的感觉如何？因为你就是跟冠军非常接近，跟第一名非常接近，然后就是差一点可能就拿到金牌。
我感觉整体来说的话，技术动作来说。还是做的比较好的，然后就可能中间第二个把失误的时候，可能自己的精力啊什么的没守住。
He said basically totally his technical control is doing great, but the second target he lost, it was like a sudden mind skip, just like this. But basically he think he's doing pretty well.
I think you are doing pretty well, and I guess a little bit disappointed because if you miss two in another final.It might be gold, not this time.
他说他觉得确实可能就是一瞬间的那个然后走神儿，还是觉得可能会觉得有点遗憾，因为就是确实跟金牌失之交臂的。Yeah, that's a little bit pity because it's very close to the gold.
Well, congratulations, and we look forward to seeing you again, perhaps at the World Championships.
他说非常感谢再次祝贺你，然后他很。很期待在这个巴库世锦赛上实际见到你。
好好好，我继续努力，继续努力。
Okay, he will making progress, step by step, and doing his great job. Okay.
谢谢，
谢谢，谢谢。
谢谢
谢
Nathan, well done. First World Cup gold. How does that feel?
Thank you. It feels amazing. Feels amazing. And to do it here with my girlfriend and baby here as well is just unbelievable, yeah.
It was a tough old final though, wasn't it? I mean, you had to be on your best form.
Yeah, I knew I couldn't afford to miss. The Chinese guy was pushing me all the way, so I had to keep my foot to the floor and keep trying to go on.
You must have felt in pretty good nick because, I mean, all but one of your qualification rounds was 25. So did you come in thinking, I've got a chance here?
You always like to think you've got a chance. It's just a natural competitor in you. So you just keep focused and keep going and see where you end up at the end.
And like you say, special because you've got your family here. How old's your baby?
4 months. Yeah, she's 4 months. So it's great to have her here.
And having said that, I guess the shooting family are family as well. And I think Aaron, who went out first, was the first to get out of his chair and cheer for you.
Yeah, I think he got a telling off as well, didn't he?
So you've done this. Is it a stepping board for the World Championships, perhaps?
Yeah, hopefully. That's next on the calendar for us. So, yeah, we'll keep training ready for that.
And perhaps best not to get ahead of ourselves and start talking about the Olympics next year.
No, not yet at all. Not yet. We'll just keep training. So,
big party tonight?
We'll see. Yeah, hopefully. I'm sure we'll have a couple of drinks somewhere.
Congratulations.
Thank you.